Please take your seats. Act two is about to start.
Everybody, I'm Alvin, and I don't like to brag, but maybe you've heard. He's been indicted. We're so excited. He's about to go to jail, and no, he won't like it.
A wrong's been righted. He can't gaslight it. You know, he wants to.
130 grand to keep me hushing. Of all investigations, this one stuck. Not January 6th or deals with Russians. And now the world knows he's a lousy.
I've been indicted, but don't get excited. Gave me millions, now I want to start a riot. He's been indicted and can't decide it.
And we know, he got you, I got you.
I hope you've enjoyed my unsealed excitement. With backing from the Appointed Sisters, featuring Liz Cheney for the appearance of bipartisanship. Our material witness, Stormy Daniels. And our star witness, Michael Cohen.
Me, a star? Listen, I got a lot more on Trump. There was a time I asked him if he had seen the latest abortion bill. He told me to just pay it. And you know, I asked him what really happened with Stormy. He insisted it was a rigged erection. Really, if I'm lying, I'm dying. I swear on a stack of Bibles.
This indictment makes up for the most disappointing 90 seconds of my life. I'm so happy I'm gonna dance down the sidewalk. Alvin?
It's a witch hunt. I'm the most innocent man of all time, it's true. By the way, Tish, this counts as a deposition. It's true, look at the law. Nobody's going to believe a Soros-backed Manhattan district attorney, Michael Cohen, You're no fixer. Frankly, I should have had you fixed. But it's no matter, because I've raised $4 million since the indictment. And now it's on to Georgia, where I just need 11,780 votes. And Rudy says I'm a free man. And in this horseface case, I never repaid anyone. Name the lowlife that says I did. And hush money. I'd never heard of it.
That money was not campaign money. Sorry, I'm giving you a fact now that you don't know. It's not campaign money. No campaign finance violation. So
they funneled it through the law firm.
Funneled through the law firm, and the president repaid it.
And in fact, settlements like this, whatever you think of them, are common, both among famous people, celebrities, and in corporate America. The result is usually known as an NDA, a non-disclosure agreement. In this case, you can believe whatever side you want to believe, but paying people not to talk about things, hush money, is ordinary in modern America.
I tell you, that is great news. Thank you, Joe Taco Pizza. It's a great flavor combo, by the way. Some say the best. Is Rhonda sanctimonious? Is he still in second?
Did somebody say seconds? Pudding. This gives me the energy to ban more books.
Hey, say this, Ron. It's time for some traffic problems.
Oh, Chris Christie, you son of a beach. You should never be a never-Trumper. I wouldn't recommend it to anyone out there. You could have been very, very special.
Don. You know if he's guilty, my lane is clear. I'll be the chosen one, God's warrior prince to sanctimonious. Knows if they nail Trump, that I'll get a bump. I'll win without a fuss. Trump's scared.
It ain't over yet, pretty boy. Chris Christie warming up. I'm the blast of hot air that'll fry your blind ambition.
Literally?
Feel my sunburn. I will roast you good.
He'll roast you good.
Like the weenie you are.
Like the weenie you are.
But still you're gonna run, run, a run, a run. But you won't get far.
No, he won't get far.
Christie and Mike Pence.
Hallelujah.
Don't have a prayer. But losers run, run, a run, a run. I'll be waiting here.
He'll be waiting here. Nikki Haley running in my prime.
Don Lemon's nuts.
Pompeo knows it's not his time.
She kicked his butt.
I'm tougher than the queen of mean. Trump's little Margie Taylor Greene. I'm set to roots like Ronnie Skeen.
Jill Biden's here.
To
candidates are just awful. By contrast, your coronation as king will be spectacular.
But I just wish I didn't have to wait 70 years and one dreadful act to get here.
Camilla, queen, please. I'm Katara Vage. Yes, that's my Brazilian drag name. I'm definitely no longer Anthony de Volder, and I'm certainly not George Santos. In fact, I'm the founder of the Inner Circle. I was at the first show in 1923, and one thing I swear in the Old Testament about is this year's Act Two is the funniest ever, except for maybe Sister Act, which I wrote. Don't believe me? Ask my friend, my good friend, Sam Bankman-Fried. Well, anyway, thank you so much for coming to Drag Queen Story Hour. Chapter One. My colleagues in Congress, the revolting children, including my mentor, upstate Congresswoman Elise Stefanik.
I understand why you're putting on that dress, George. Your people call it Purim.
My people.
I'm Lauren Boebert, but you can call me by my initials, AR15. AR is A-OK. AOC, not so much.
And I'm Marjorie Taylor Greene, and I'm not gonna let this show drag me down. I'm known for heckling the president, conniving with the speaker, and Jewish space lasers.
And you can imagine accused pedophile Matt Gaetz, the voice of reason. In this show, there's groom for everyone.
And I'm Hallelujah. Congressman Jim Jordan, and I am writing to my pen pal, Alvin Bragg.
Oh, 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 oh. Never again will they claim majority. Never again will they win a rigged election. And we can't forget how hard we fight
for the right to cause a little bit of chaos. Never again
will Pelosi take charge.
Never again
will anyone heckle March.
Never again
will you question that.
More guns make us safer.
More guns.
We know how to tear the country apart. We know how, cause you know that we are revolting children making revolting jokes. And love to be revolting and fighting all things woke. We'll be revolting children till our revolting's done. And we'll have the Congress bolting. We're revolting. Ah! So don't corrupt our children. We crave a simpler time. And we refuse to teach them about our country's crimes. We'll be revolting children till democracy is done. And we'll have the Congress bolting. We're revolting.
We need a national divorce.
I'll heckle Joe and scream until my voice is hoarse.
I date 17-year-olds with no remorse.
And I will look the other way, of course.
The MAGA man who we endorse.
It's not insulting.
We're revolting.
We are revolting children making revolting jokes. We love.
Look at them. Oh, they're terrific. Aren't they great? It reminds me of my own kids, Don Jr., Ivanka, Marsha, Jan, and Bobby. They're all really great. They're really great. I still can't believe I got indicted before her.
Oh, yes, it's true. These revolting children are my friends. But I'm also best friends forever with AOC. It's true. I even made her dress for the Met Gala. I made it out of clay, like a dreidel. My heritage really influences everything I do.
Please, Georgie, I'll tell you who'll pay for this dress. The top 1%, just like Uncle Bernie Sanders always taught us.
As Hakeem Jeffries, head of the Democratic Caucus, it's important for us Democrats to keep our house in order. No ethical issues, AOC.
My Brooklyn borough is correct. And as your Senate Majority Leader, we cannot afford to have the GOP gaslight us on ethics. No gaslighting and no gas stove.
And I'm Kirsten Gillibrand, New York's junior senator. And to be perfectly frank, and I mean frank, I've got to prepare to fend off that Cuomo comeback.
Oh, easy, easy, everybody. Just move in my general direction.
To the left, to the left. To the left, to the left.
Oh.
To the left, to the left.
Everything you know, push it far to the left. Higher taxes on my dress. Free-for-alls and the CVS. Chuck, let's face it, you're past your prime. Could you walk and tweet at the same time? And you cater to the upper class. I gave you a pass, you'd be out on your ass.
Always on the TikTok, talking about cows and college debt. Suddenly, you're the queen of the hill and the internet. You make me sweat.
You should be afraid of me because I'm AOC. No matter how you try to spin it, if I ran a race with you, I'd win it, baby.
AOC primary, it makes us have to pee. We could be out of jobs by tomorrow.
So don't you ever for a second get to think.
The squad, I outranked them. What did I think when I whacked out Franken? Because it was untrue. Flipping and flopping to appear more like you. You're just 33. Now I'm freaked, you're coming after me.
I used to be a centrist in my Sunday interviews. Moderates, we all wish she'd go back to serving booze. Gotta change up our views.
Hi, my name is Hakeem. She makes me want to scream.
You are a puppet for Pelosi. You and the banks are way too cozy, baby.
Can we just be mainstream? Feels like a balance beam.
It's time for all of you to get with it. Don't you ever for a second get to thinking you're irreplaceable.
To the left, to the left. Making Democrats hustle way to the left.
Oh, Goop, I did it again. Look out. I can't believe I missed half a day of skiing for this.
Oh, Gwyneth, I wish you well. We've covered the right. We've covered the left. In our next chapter in our story hour, we're going to take you to the most beautiful place in the world, Albany. I've been there 10 billion times, but also I've never been there at all.
Well, as the governor of this great state, I, Kathy Hochul, play it right down the middle, middle of the road. I even got a middle seat on the Long Island Railroad. You know, come to think of it, those middle seats, they're always available. But it gives me plenty of room to govern from that position.
Girlfriend, it's time you recognize where the real power lies, with me,
the Senate Majority Leader, Andrea Stewart Cousins.
This bad bitch can rock, got my hands dirty. I clean Zeldin's clock and I look pretty.
But I'm the bitch who's ruling in the building. I blocked the judge committee, wasn't willing. And I'm about to tell you how I'm feeling. How you feeling? How you feel right now?
Oh, I'm thriving under all this pressure. My photo op is what I treasure. Cause I'm so much better.
Turn up the music. Let's start a fight.
She took a bruising cause her judge was far too right.
Short side.
Guess the power's mine.
Turn up the music. Let's start a fight.
First girl in history to take the oath in Albany. That's right. Cause the power's mine.
Controls the vote. Kind of bossy, Yonkers lady reforming the bail, and she won't dial it back no more.
So you're out of luck, out of touch. I need no more gov to get stuff. I am the queen, the Senate dean. I am the boss right now.
Oh, I'm thriving under all that pressure. My photo op is what I treasure.
Music. Let's start a fight. I-87 bitches leading all money. That's right. And the bath dance time.
Give it up for Lizzo Kruger on the flutes.
Well, Andrea, I'm so glad you and I are singing the same tune, right? But I've got other issues to worry about, and the one giving me indigestion? Congestion pricing.
Yeah, my Staten Island constituents have to pay $100 to reach Manhattan. That's a bridge too far. Take it from me, election denier Nicole Malliotakis.
That's right, and I'm Josh Geiheimer, the freaking Joe Manchin of New Jersey.
And I am Idanis Rodriguez, the only Adams commissioner who got stuck on Rat Patrol on at one. And how did I get stuck on rats and traffic?
The MTA wants, the DOT needs.
Anything they want done, baby, not doing it naturally.
Cause we are the drivers.
I need my car.
It's not for me. You can't read my easy pass now. Every driver has to say.
Congestion pricing, not gonna pay. All my bridge and tunnel drivers, and they all have to say no.
Different mode.
emission zero, every driver has to pay.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. No, no, no.
Oh, I can sense your needs cause of mismanaged deeds.
I can make a crime of your budget in my mind.
And when it comes down to some good old-fashioned pork,
forget it.
Pricing, not gonna pay. All the bridge and tunnel drivers, they all have to stay.
Congestion pricing, it's not for me. You can't read my easy pass now, every driver has to say.
Below 60th, just ask me, or need a road diet. No cash drop to compare, more bike lanes. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Congestion pricing.
Oh boy, if that doesn't work out, I don't know how I'm going to bail out the MTA.
Well, good evening. I'm former three-term mayor Mike Bloomberg, noted billionaire. And for some reason, Kathy, I like you. You're way more competent than the last Kathy I knew, Kathy Black, my one-time schools chancellor. I'll put the monies for your little park and ride scheme with some spare change I found in my Bermuda lounge chair. If there's a ways to get a return on my investment, at long last.
Bloomy, please. You should have asked me for the money. I'm loaded. I'm the guy who paid for all of those Clarence Thomas vacations. All from my rock-solid account at Signature Bank.
Freeze, Mr. Santos, as the Attorney General of the great state of New York. I have something to say about your funny money. Why is everything you buy $199.99?
I'm Sadie Horowitz, a pissed-off voter in your district. I'd like to know how you found meals so cheap and how did you get away with making me believe that you were a nice Jewish boy?
How could you believe me when I said I'm Jewish when you know I've been a liar all my life?
You said you worked for Goldman Sachs, but that's not the truth.
I learned my business skills at a school called Baruch.
How did I believe you that your name is Santos? Should've known that's not a Jewish name at all.
I can see you're not athletic at all. You couldn't have been a champ at Baruch Volleyball.
How could you believe it when I said I'm truthful when you know I've been a liar?
You sure have been a liar.
A cross-dressing liar.
A cross-dressing liar.
Oh my dog.
Must have all been insane.
Indictment in vain.
Jill, what a gift that guy is to my re-election chances. Sure makes my gaffes look like a walk in the park by comparison.
And Joe, you really dodged a bullet on hiring a new labor secretary. Thank goodness you avoided the tall man from Brooklyn.
Kyrie Irving? He got traded.
No, Bill de Blasio. You'll never believe what he's up to now.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again. What?
Hi. I love your music. I know who you are. I love your music.
Thank you very much.
I can't believe it. Today's the day I meet Harry Styles, right here in Grand Central Terminal.
I'm not Harry Styles.
You're not?
I'm Paul Simon. Who are you?
I'm Bill de Blasio.
Oh, right, right. The professor. Yeah. Hey, I got an idea. You know, once upon a time, I made a guy a star. I bet you I could do it again. Move over, Art Garfunkel. New York, get ready for the hottest new duo in the city, Simon and de Blasio. I'm sitting here in Grand Central Station.
Got a ticket but no destination.
I knew Bill de Blasio.
Bill de Blasio was a friend of mine, and you're no Bill de Blasio.
I have another idea. New York, get ready for the next hottest trio to hit the city. Simon and de Blasio and de Blasio. I'm sitting here in Grand Central Station.
Got a ticket, but no destination. Ooh, for governor I thought I'd make a run, but Utica no winters ain't much fun. Where once I took progressive stands,
now I'm a singer in a three-man band. Homeward bound.
I can't quit politics.
Homeward bound. Home.
What about the Senate?
Home.
I just know I'd win it.
Home, where my love lies waiting silently for me.
Every day bewilders me. No Brian Lehrer, MSNBC.
Ooh.
Just sitting around waiting for the call from 1010 Winds inside City Hall. No COVID pressers, mine to host.
I'd even love a chat with the New York Post.
Homeward bound.
Hey, I ran for president.
Homeward bound. Home.
A congressional seat.
Home.
In my district, real sweet.
Home. Where my love lies waiting silently for me.
Tonight I'll dream of policies about housing, crime, the economy.
Ooh.
But why do the polls all seem so gray?
Come on, New York, I gave you pre-K.
I hear the voters from the slope to his bay. It's Bill de Blasio all the way. Homeward bound.
Just give me one more chance.
Homeward bound. Home.
Time to turn back the clocks.
Home.
I'll even hate the Red Sox.
Home. Where my love lies waiting silently for me.
silently for me.
How do you follow that? I'll tell you one thing, folks. That'll teach me to ever even consider relying on a mayor of New York City.
Hold up, Mr. President. Hold up. First, I need to turn on my microphone.
You want to say that again?
How about now? First, you won't send us any money for asylum seekers. Then you do send the convention to the Windy City.
Come on, man. You must be high. It was always going to be Chicago. They had it coming.
Oh, rats.
Well, if it'll make you feel any better, I'll put Kamala Harris on it right now.
Oh, I may have been late, by the way, getting to the border, but I got to Hoboken by 9 a.m. What do you think of the view, honey?
As a New Jersey native, it's mishpacha. And it would have been nice to have the convention closer to home.
Well then, what's our best path forward?
Well, he is 80.
Why do you think I joined the ticket?
I'm N.J. Birkin in the lobby of the Ziegfeld with a breaking news update. Let's go now live to our correspondent, Jillian Jorgensen, in the ballroom. Jillian?
N.J., I'm here at the Ziegfeld Ballroom, and we're getting word about where Mayor Adams was during the first act. He was at a restaurant. I'm being told it's pronounced Labaya. Here's some footage of what he was up to. So there you have it. He's at Labaya with a pair of brothers who just want to have a good time. Nothing shady there. NJ, back to you.
Jillian, thank you. The 10-day AccuWeather forecast coming up.
Well, Jill, it's no hyperbole, but my dad always said, Joey, it's time to bring the act to a close. My 40 years have earned me no respect here. They call me Sleepy Joe an awful lot. The loons across the aisle pinch every dime here and spend a lot.
Fox News guys told whopping lies for ratings. That sure cost old man Murdoch quite a lot. He really did not get what he had paid for, yet spent a lot.
Spend a lot. Spend a lot. We know it sounds a bit bizarre.
And spend a lot, spend a lot. Big bucks will take you far.
Some think we've shelled out far too many greenbacks. A trillion here and there did help a lot. In truth, there's simply not a more expensive spot for paying ever aftering than here.
Spend a lot.
We keep on pumping out the dough. Yes, and spend a lot.
Spend a lot.
cash always beats your foes.
I forgot the secret papers in my Corvette.
We shot the sky balloon down from the sky.
I stunned the world with hijinks on the jet steps in Spendalot. Spend a lot. You know we give the right of fit. But in spend a lot, we don't really give a darn. Some say I am the nation's sweet old grandpa. I'll squint my way again right to the top.
In short, there's simply not a candidate who's got a better chance of winning. 'Cause we really spent a lot.
Nice. At least one mayor showed up tonight, huh? Welcome, Mayor Adams! As we approach the end here, wrapping up the show has been a little bit of a challenge, so I asked a longtime cast member, ChatGPT, to help us with the ending. Alrighty then!
I mean, when you've got friends like mine, aren't I nice? Aren't I normal? Side by side.
He is such a cutie, isn't he? Cutie?
Ice creams his vice. He has decent morals.
Never gets indicted. I envy that.
By side.
80 years young. Life's sweet.
Side by
we
side,
just so fond of him.
By side,
and biting my tongue, yeah, that's me.
Like him, guess we will vote for him.
I'll hit the trail and stump for Biden. Side by side,
I like his stance on Ukraine.
Side by side,
no more rat tails, please go. To hide in
side by side.
We're always here when you need us.
Biden's boring and Trump is crazy.
You could vote for Nikki Haley.
So you have some problems as you run again, Joe? Do what I do. Blame the rats.
We're in the church. We're in the steeple. Open the door.
What could we do without you?
city shines. How sweet, side by side. No more Ratman. Stay neat, side by side. Year after year, older and older, side by side. Adams is here, lending a shoulder.
Quite a night for us because just before the show, we found out that one of our youngest members had passed away last night. His name is Connor Skelding, same age as my children, and we decided that we were giving it all up for him tonight. So I hope you enjoyed our show. This is for Connor. He would not want us to be down. He would not want us to be sad. He would want us to give it all we got, and we did. So thank you for being here. And I have a million people to thank tonight, and I don't even know where to begin. Mary Alice Williams, who keeps us all coming on stage. She's got lists this long backstage. I mean, crazy. Holly Christman with, you know, all of the video stuff and, you know, Catherine Warfeld, the Ziegfeld Senior Catering Sales Manager, for welcoming us for a second year. Thank you. To the lighting services provided by Innovative Stage Productions and its AV Director John Healy and Vadim Ledvin of Organic Design. To Marcus Mendoza of Majestic Prompting, to the City Council. City Council, Brad Weeks, for graciously allowing us to rehearse for a few months in the City Council chamber and allowing us to park. Woo! To Con Edison for sponsoring our cocktail party, to Lisa Colangelo, Winnie Hugh, woo! Catherine Piper, our costumes and props department. Lily Beth Gonzalez, I don't know what we would do without you. She makes us all look beautiful, even though we all have bags under our eyes, from trying to go to work, argue with our news directors about getting the damn time off, and, you know, trying to rehearse 4 days a week, and, like, we all look beautiful in the end, don't we? Yeah, thank you. To our Inner Circle Writing Committee, unbelievably brilliant, Andrew Siff, Jillian Jorgensen, Dave Tyson. Our show director, Sonia Rincon of WABC-TV. A big thanks to Ken Fisher, our attorney at Cozen O'Connor, and his partner, David Sunshine. To Beth Karras, who keeps this Inner Circle act together. This doesn't just happen over a few months. It takes all freaking year. As soon as this show is done tonight, we are working on next year, and we hope you will all come back. To Susan Watts, our Inner Circle photographer. Inner Circle photographer, Melanie McAvoy, our event planner. To the Inner Circle officers, Jillian Jorgensen of New York One, our chairperson, Eileen LaPalmer of Pix 11, Samantha Liebman of 1010 Wins, and next year's Inner Circle president, baby, it's all yours, our mayor, James Board of Pix 11, to our longest serving member, the dean of the Inner Circle, Ed Silverfarb, who played King Charles. Most of all, you have no idea what you have no idea what they go through to try to get us to do this at the same time. Tony Parisi, thank you. Patiently choreographed our entire show. Steve Silverstein, Inner Circle pianist and assistant music director. Madeline Rubenstein, the poor thing, rehearsal pianist. I don't know how she puts up with us. Gene Schultens, who puts it all together. Who says, oh, you can't sing in that key? Oh, I'll make sure the band goes down an eighth or a half or whatever the hell you do, Gene, but it's amazing, amazing. I can't even, like, the words will not come out of my mouth to express my appreciation for Kathy Beaver and the Inner Circle band. We had an amazing year. It was testing all of us, a big test for all of us. And finally, to my husband, Giovanni Rossini, and my entire family, my sister, my children, Giovanni, Alexander, Domenico, Jacob, Emily, Nicole, thank you. You haven't seen much of me, but I'm back now, baby. It's all for you. And Mayor Adams is up next. Good luck with your show, Mayor. We'll see you all next year. Thank you. Woo!
Okay. Inner Circle Parade.